In the last video, we learned about Jacobians and the theory of changing variables and how that works for doing double integrals. In this video, we're going to do some double integrals. So the first one is we want to compute the integral of e to the x plus 2y over a parallelogram. And this is a parallelogram with vertices at 2, 1, 4, 0, 2, negative 1, and the origin. And the way we're going to do it is we're going to pick new coordinates, u and v, so that in the new coordinates, this point winds up being 1, 0, this winds up being 0, 1, this winds up being 1, 1, and this region D in the new coordinates is just the unit square. So the way we do that is we just say let x, y be u times 2, 1 plus v times 2, negative 1. So when u is 1 and v is 0, you just get 1 times 2, 1, plus 0, and that's this point. And when v is 1 and u is 0, you just get this point. And this is the sum of the two, so that's where u equals 1 and v equals 1. Now, if you write this out, you write it out coordinate by coordinate, you get that x is 2u plus 2v, and y is u minus v. And x plus 2y, the v's cancel, you get that that's 4u. And so our integrand was e to the x plus 2y. Our integrand becomes e to the 4u. And the region of integration is the unit square. So we have to figure out our Jacobian. But that's pretty easy because x was 2u plus 2v. So the derivative with respect to u is 2, derivative with respect to v is 2. Y was u minus v, so derivative with respect to u is 1, derivative with respect to v is minus 1. So the Jacobian is just the determinant of this matrix, and that's negative 4. Notice that the ratio of the areas is not negative 4, the ratio of the areas is 4. What goes into the change of variable formula is the absolute value of the Jacobian. So the integral of the original function over the original region is the integral of the function rewritten in terms of u, that's e to the 4u, times the absolute value of the Jacobian, du dv. And that becomes the integral as v goes from 0 to 1, the integral of u goes from 0 to 1, 4e to the u du dv. Integral of 4e to the u du is e to the 4e to the 4u du is e to the 4u. Evaluated at 0 and 1 gives you e to the 4th minus 1. Integrate that from 0 to 1, and you get e to the 4th minus 1. Okay. In our next example, we're going to use a rounder example. We're going to try to integrate over the interior of an ellipse. We let D be an ellipse with height 2 and width 3, that is A equals 3, B equals 2, centered at the point 1, 0. So the equation for that is x minus 1 squared over 3 squared plus y squared over 2 squared equals 1. And we want to integrate x squared over that region. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to rescale things so that first of all we move the ellipse over so it's centered at the origin, then we're going to rescale it so it becomes the unit circle. We do that by letting u be x minus 1 over 3 and v be y over 2. So that means that our original equation just becomes u squared plus v squared equals 1, and we're just looking at the interior of the unit circle. Now if you rewrite that in terms of x in terms of u, multiply by 3, add 1, x equals 3u plus 1, y is 2v. So our original function, which was x squared, becomes 3u plus 1 squared, becomes 9u squared plus 6u plus 1. And the region that we're integrating in the uv plane is just the interior of the unit circle. Okay. Our Jacobian is pretty simple. The derivative of x with respect to u is 3. Derivative of x with respect to v is 0. Derivative of y with respect to u is 0, derivative of y with respect to v is 2. So that's just that determinant is 6. So our change of variable formula says that the integral of x squared dA over the original region is you rewrite x squared in terms of the u variables, u and v variables, you multiply by the Jacobian, which is 6, and you integrate that du dv. Okay, and we're going to do that one term at a time. First, we're going to look at this term, 1 times 6 du dv. Well, the integral of 6 du dv is just 6 times the area. The area of the unit disk is pi, pi r squared, so that gives us 6 pi. The integral of 6u times 6 du dv, that's the integral of 36u du dv, and that's 0 by symmetry. Has as much to the right as of the y-axis as to the left of the y-axis. It's an odd function viewed as a function of u. And finally, the remaining term, the 9u squared times 6, well, we do another change of variables. We change from uv to r theta. We use polar coordinates not in the original xy space, but we use polar coordinates in uv space. That is, we let u be r cosine theta and v be r sine theta. So we rewrite this in terms of r and theta. U squared is r cosine theta, so we get r squared cosine squared theta. And then we have another Jacobian. We did a second change of variables, so we have another Jacobian. We have don't have dr d theta, we have r dr d theta. And now we do our integral. Integrating with respect to r is easy. Integral of r cubed from 0 to 1 is a quarter, so we get 27 halves. And then to do the integral of cosine squared, we use a trig identity. Cosine squared is 1 half of 1 plus cosine 2 theta. Integral of cosine 2 theta is 0. Integral of 1 from 0 to 2 pi is 2 pi. So we get 27 pi over 2. When we add that to our 6 pi that we had earlier, we get a total of 39 pi over 2, and that's our final answer.